Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Emily and I talk a lot about Salesforce. Today we're going to be starting a new series on my channel that is real life Salesforce projects. So I got this comment the other day about how to take a contact report and send an email out to the contacts on that report. So that's exactly what we're going to be doing. So I have created this contact report. Let's go ahead and hop into reports. And go into the contact report. All right, so what I have here, a few things. We've got the first name, the last name, the company, but most importantly, we have their emails. From this contact report, after you've created it, saved, run it, let's go to this caret over here and we're going to add to campaign. So now we can do a bunch of different things. We can add it to the current campaign or we could create a new campaign. I'm going to add this to an email marketing campaign, May 22, that I already created. Select member status. This could be sent or responded, or you could create a new status on the back end. I'm just going to keep this as sent. And what we could do is we can update existing campaign member status. So let's say half of these had a campaign member status of responded. If we wanted to keep those half as responded, we would keep the member status. But if we wanted to push them all back to sent and start them over in the campaign process, then we would overwrite. I'm going to select overwrite and submit. So then they're all starting off on the same footing. So right now it is going to send me a quick email of if it has completed, and I just got the email and I'm not going to edit that out, just so then you know how long it took for that email to send. I was still talking, so it didn't take very long. I'm going to go into campaigns and go to email marketing campaign. Okay, so now we have those 20 campaign members that were on that report into our campaign. So campaigns are really, really awesome, and feel free to skip like 30 seconds to a minute while I go on a data spiel, because I personally love data. I think data is really fantastic. When you have a campaign, the most important thing that you can have is data. This is going to help us make decisions in the future on where to put our revenue dollars, where to put our marketing spend. If email marketing campaigns are what's working, then we're going to want to do more of that. If they're not working, then we're going to want to stop doing that. The way that you figure out if it's working or if it's not working is through the data that you put in these fields, fill them out. This goes for more than just campaigns. This goes for opportunities, leads, accounts, contacts, so that we know what works, what doesn't work, what we need to stop, what we need to start, what we need to continue. All right, spiel over. All right, let's go back to related. So here we are on the campaign members related list. Related lists are just all the records that are related to this record or associated with it. So by adding those campaign members that were on that contact list, we related them to this campaign. So we can add leads, can add contacts, already done that. We can manage campaign members, import leads and contacts. Let's say we had a CSV of an email list that we wanted to send to from Salesforce from another system, then we'd be able to import that as a CSV. It has to be a CSV, not an Excel file, or else the system won't read it, or you'll have to do it a different way. I am going to choose this last option and send a list email. So now here we can build out that email that we want to send out to the campaign. Let's say summer deals for you to splash into summer. Then we can write the email body here. Thanks for being on my email list. And this would be a great place to plug that, hey, I have an email list. So if you want to join the Salesforce Emily email list, go to salesforceemily.com and you should see it on the right hand column over there on my website. So now let's go ahead and look at review. This is what it's going to be. Thanks for being on my email list. That's going to be the subject it's going to send to these contacts. other things we can do, we can change the font, we can add pictures, add bullet points, all those fun things. We can save as a draft, send later. So if you want to schedule it out for a certain time, you can do that. I'm going to hit send. And there you go. The email was queued. So what that means is as soon as Salesforce gets to the emails that are first in the queue, then they will send out your email. And actually, as we're just talking now, I got that email list that it has sent. So that is how you send a contact list, an email, a marketing email. So thank you so much for joining me. If you have any other real life project ideas for me, be sure to leave them in the comments down below and I'll try and get back to you as soon as possible. I will actually add the playlist that I'll be starting in the description if you would like to check that out. I do have a few other real life projects that I'll be adding there as well. Like, subscribe, do all those fun things. You can join the email list again at salesforceemily.com. It'll be on the right hand column. And if you'd like to check out any of my courses, you can do so down below in the descriptions on Udemy. So thank you so much for joining me and I'll catch you in the next one.